Welcome back to this video tutorial series on building a WordPress theme in blocks. By the end of this video, we will have a homepage for our WordPress theme that will display the site title, tagline, and primary navigation. When a new project is created in blocks, you will be greeted by the Startup Details window. This window allows you to quickly apply some of the core characteristics for the type of site or theme you are building. First, I need to give my site a name. When creating a WordPress theme in blocks, the value entered into the site name field will be used as the theme name. So when my theme is installed into WordPress, this is the name that will be displayed alongside the theme's preview image. To improve the in-app previewing experience, I'm going to set up the web address to the URL of my local WordPress development site. Blocks will use this URL to pull in content from the WordPress database during in-app previewing. This step is optional, so don't worry if you don't have a WordPress site URL to enter right now. It's worth noting, Blocks can also pull in content from a live WordPress site, so if you are redesigning a theme for a client who is already running their site on WordPress, just enter their current URL into the web address field, and Blocks will let you preview your theme with their site's content. Finally, I'm going to set the CMS pop-up menu to WordPress. Because I entered a web address during setup, Blocks is now asking if I would like to load some simulation data from the provided site. This data will be displayed in my theme when I preview it within Blocks. For a more streamlined and accurate design workflow, it's worth having this content, so I'm going to select Yes. Once Blocks has finished collecting the simulation data, I can see all available content via the WordPress Data pop-up menu, which is located in the main toolbar. A green tick indicates available content, and a red cross indicates no content. The red cross is here, let me know, the WordPress site doesn't have any custom post or custom field data, which is correct. For the majority of this demonstration, I will be using the standard Blocks in-app preview mode to test my theme. However, at some stages, I will also export and test my theme in WordPress. I'm using MAMP to run a local WordPress installation. To help speed up the process of previewing my theme with MAMP, I'm going to assign a dedicated export location. This means every time I export, Blocks will know exactly where I want the export to be placed. This saves me reselecting a location every time I export. To set a dedicated export location, I'll click the menu icon in the top left corner of the main design window. This will open the project settings. From here, I'll select the Export tab, and then click the button labeled Select Export Location. I'm now asked to select the location that I would like my theme to be placed each time I export. Because I'm using MAMP to locally test my theme, I'll set the export location to the WordPress theme folder, which is located in my MAMP domain folder. In the WordPress theme folder, I'm going to create a new folder for my theme and name it with the same value that I previously assigned as the site name. Now, whenever I export my theme from Blocks, all of the files that make up my custom WordPress theme will be placed into this folder. That's the project setup complete. It's time to start building. I'll start by adding the navigation section to my page. I'll do this by clicking the plus button in the center of the design canvas to reveal the block bar. I'm going to select one of the pre-made navigation blocks. Because the first block I added to the page contains a navigation brick, the block is automatically inserted into the top global area. It's important that the site navigation is placed in the top global area, as I want it to show on every page of my theme. The next task is to hook up the contents of the navigation block so that the values it displays for the logo and navigation menu match those set in the WordPress backend. First, I'm going to select the logo brick on the design canvas. I want my WordPress site title to be displayed here. To do that, I'll set the logo's data source to site title. Next, I'll select the navigation brick and set its data source to WordPress primary menu. Let's preview that and check out the results. As you can see, the site title and menu items from my local WordPress site are populating my theme's navigation block. Let's move on and create the header section. First, I'll add a structure block. Then, I'll select the column within the block and click the Add Brick button to reveal the brick bar. From the brick bar, I'll select the header text. I'd like this text header to display the WordPress site tagline. In order to do that, I'll set the data source for the header to Site Tagline. Before I preview the results, I'll quickly smarten up this layout. I'll center the heading text, increase the font size, and change the placeholder content to something more meaningful. Now, I'll select the header block, apply a background image, and increase the padding. Finally, I'm going to reselect the heading brick and set the text color to white. Let's switch to preview mode and check the results. You can now see the header is populated with the WordPress site tagline from my local WordPress site. In the next video, I will continue to build out the homepage of my theme and incorporate a post loop, which will display the site's blog posts.